Players, get ready, please. Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Thomas Gebhardt, Hungary. And on my left, Chang Jun-woo, Chinese Taipei. Chang Jun-woo to serve. Love all. Play. One, love. Service over. One all. Fault. Two, one. Three. One. Service over. Two, three. Halt. Service over. Four, two. Up. Service over. Three, four. Four, all. Fault. Service over. Five, four. Service over. Five, all. Six, five. Service over. Six, all. Service over. Seven, six. Thank you. 8-6. Ten, six. Eleven, six. Interval. Court 4, 20 seconds. Court 4, 20 seconds.
Umpire,
11-6. Play. Service over. 7-11. Service over. 12-7. Service over. 8-12. Service over. 13-8. Fault. Service over. 9-13. out 13. Service over. 14-12. Jank. What is that? Thank you. Fourteen-12. Play. Service over. 13-14. Service over. 15-13. Service over. 14-16. Service over. 17-15. Service over. 16-19. Service over. 20, game point, 16. Game. First game won by Chang Jun Woo, 21-16.
We will remind you that flash photography is forbidden. No.
You ready? Second game. Love all. Play. One love. Service over. One all. Fault. Service over. 2-1. Three, one. Oh. Service over. 2-3. Fault. Service over. 4-2. Service over. 3-4. Four. All. Service over. 5-4.
We will now start.
Service over. 5 all. Service over. 6-0. Service over. 7-6. Service over.
From Indonesia. Court number 2. Umpire of the LFA. Service judge. Please stay on the server.
7-0. Service over. 8-7. Service over. 8-0. 8. Service over. 9-10. Interval. Court 4, 20 seconds. Court 4, 20 seconds. Yeah. 11-10. Play. Service over. 11-12. Thank you. Service over. 13-12. Service over. 13-13. Fault. Service over. 14-13. Service over. 14 all. Service over. 15-14. Service over. 15-16. Sorry.
Can we get Paul Jennings and Mark King from England to the meeting point? And also Pedro Rasmussen and Thomas Dunbo from Denmark. Carl Jennings and Mark King.
Thank you. Play. Service over. 17-18. Service over. 19-18. Service over. 19 all. Service over. 20, match point 19. Service over. 20, all. Service over. 21, 20. Game. Well done. Match won by Changjun U. 21-16, 22-20.
Thank you.
So good luck for the four of you. Good luck. Good luck. Let's toss. Racket or shuttle? Shuttle for you, okay? Racket, you decide. You will serve? Service or receive? Oh, sorry, receive. Okay, and you stay on this side? Okay.
So the Brits won the coin toss. Welcome back. We are back, both me and Nils. And we are going to check out a men's doubles now. It's men's double 40. And if you watched previously, I think one of the first game or second game of the day. The second game of the day, yeah, it's Carl Jennings. On the far side of the court right now, he played a mixed doubles earlier in a previous game that we showed. So we have a couple of people here who's been with us a couple of rounds. Luck of the draw or unluck of the draw, whatever you prefer. So we have Carl Jennings, away from the camera in white. To the right, and we have his partner, Mark King, near the camera to the right. And they are up against two Danish players. We have Peter Rasmussen, and we have Thomas Stamgaard. And yes, that's Rasmussen, at the far side of the court. And Thomas, close to the camera. So, do you know anything about the players?
I know that Jennings and King have won the All England either this year, last year, or both.
All England Masters.
Doubles, yeah.
Yeah.
And Peter Rasmussen, I don't think he's won the All England, but he's won the World Championships in singles, men's singles.
Was that in Ankara?
Or was no, the World the not the seniors, the World Championships, the real World Championships for the professionals.
Very cool.
Very interesting match. He was down 13-6 or something like that in the second and lost the first game and came back to win that one. And he and Thomas, I think, are old schoolmates from high school. So they've known each other a long time.
Yeah. If you know it, if you know your double partner, usually that means better coordination and better communication.
Of course, of course. Yeah,
the longer you play, the better. The better you get to play together. So Peter and Thomas, they are second seeded in this competition. And Carl and Mark.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Carl Jennings, marking England. On my left, Peter Rasmussen, Thomas Stango, Denmark. Mark King to serve to Thomas Stango. Love ball, play.
Looks like it usually does at the beginning. Pretty safe shots, long rallies, feel each other out.
Yeah. The Danes are off to a great start here.
Service over, 1-4.
Yeah, I'm not that good at tactics in doubles, so maybe if you have some tactical notes. But it feels maybe it's too early to see those tactics.
Yeah, I think at least the English players are still nervous. They're not moving right yet.
Okay.
And a service error usually means that you're nervous also.
Great elevation from Carl.
Service over.
Super
two,
tall and,
six.
And a high jump. Great good angles.
Service over. 7-2.
Yeah, these two latest points confirm my suspicions that both couples can play doubles with the right tactics and everything at a high speed, but I think the Danes have a little more deception in their shots than the English couple.
Fault. Service over. 3-9. Service over. 10-3.
There seems to be some gaps in the coverage.
That was also a deceptive shot from Thomas.
Fault. 11-3. Interval.
Yeah, the tempo is really high.
Yeah.
Danes always come up on top.
Can listen here to what Nick Ponting is. Well, one thing I heard is that they're a bit short and they need to take a little of the pace off.
Look at the screen.
Was too short. The lift was too short.
Yeah.
Service over.
That shot works on
five,
every level.
12.
Even in the Olympic finals, if you shoot in between them, oftentimes no one takes it or both take it. Good fix here. Yes. Yeah, once again. Deceptive shots.
Deception from Thomas again there to get the opening. It's more the English players'
service
game.
Over.
They want to get
six,
the lift and
14.
Use their height. They're both very tall players and usually are not as fast as shorter
Thomas
players. Then.
Yeah. I'm not sure if King, he didn't give 100%, but it feels like his match was kind of soft there. It wasn't as...
Yeah, he just wants to set it up for Carl there.
Yeah, okay. It's better distance on the lift. Yeah.
Service over, 15-6. Service over, 7-15. Service over, 16-7.
And again, way too short.
17-7. Play. Service over, 8-17.
I still feel like the English players haven't really gotten into their groove yet.
Yeah.
Service over.
Yeah, good counter
18,
to the fix serve.
8. Yeah. Nineteen.
The English players just
20,
have to
game point eight.
Try to come back in the next game.
Game.
Let's see if Nick Ponting can come up with something
first
to help them.
Won by Peter Rasmussen,
that's the English
Thomas
coach.
Stauko, 21-8.
Yes.
Coaching the wrong team, almost.
Pardon?
Almost started coaching the wrong team, looked like.
Yeah, no, he was saying something else to the Danish guys. They knew each other from before.
Okay. So, yeah, Danes look relaxed. Look at Thomas.
The Danes are always very relaxed. They're just here to have fun.
Yeah. And the English look a bit more concerned.
Yes, as they should be.
Yeah.
Thomas, don't play with the shuttle, please. Thank you.
Yeah.
Who's serving? Okay, thank you. Who's receiving, Mark? Line judges, thank you. Second game. Lofall, play. Service over. One love.
Nice drop there.
She's definitely more settled now.
Service over, 1-1.
That was a pretty good starting lift there.
2-1.
Thomas.
I think he forgot that they're left-handed because he played a shot that you usually play on the backhand side.
Oh, they're double lefties. I didn't notice. That's pretty rare.
3-1.
Yeah. It is.
Service over, 5-2.
That has to change. On this level, if you meet two lefties, that has to change your tactic quite a bit, right?
You have to keep it in mind anyway, and yeah, not play these shots that you usually
service
play
over, three,
without even thinking
five.
About it.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. Like, you know, you meet so many righties that
yeah,
some of the shots, like pushing back in specific corners.
That's correct. You have to think of your shots more.
4-5. Yeah, change.
They should be used to it now after one game.
Yeah, they look a lot more comfortable right now.
Service over, 6-4. Fault. Service over, 5-6.
In the middle again, just as you said.
Right in the middle.
6-6.
Good shot. That's good.
Service over.
It's good positioning.
7-6.
Have the Danes are trying to keep the tempo up, and the English players are trying to slow it down, take a little pace off it, but So far the Danes
eight,
are winning.
Six.
Ooh.
9-6. Service fault called. Service over. 7-9.
Could you pull the shuttle up a bit just before the
yeah,
serve?
When he's going to flick it, yeah.
Yeah.
Service over. 10-7.
Both Danish players are moving very well, covering the court extremely well, and taking the shuttle early, so they're not giving the English players a chance, really.
11-7, interval.
And you can really see that they're very relaxed and they are comfortable with the opponent and what they're doing.
Yeah.
And it's easy to reach the balls if you're in a good mood and you're relaxed.
But they shouldn't be speaking to someone.
The umpire is
outside.
He's glaring at them now.
Yeah.
11-7, play. 12-7.
It's good.
13-7.
It was a good deceptive
wait,
shot
wait.
And a
is
good
it
angle.
14, right? Yeah. Sorry. 14-7.
Great defense from the English couple.
8-15.
We got Peter moving all over the place there. Is much too short.
17-9.
I don't think the lifts are particularly short. They're pretty long, but they're just too short for this good of opponent.
Okay, they are. They need to be past the first service line.
Yeah, and I think they're landing right about there. And I think that might be fine for some opponents.
Okay.
Yeah.
Fault. 19-9.
I think you have such a little margin for error with the lifts that it's hard to not do them too hard or too short.
20 match point 9. Service over 10-20.
And the match
Eight.
Is over.
That was a really quick match.
Yeah.
Was it
18 minutes.
18
the
minutes.
First game was in
what
10
late?
Minutes, and the second game took only 8 minutes.
Yeah.
What late?
And the
what
Danes
late?
Managed to keep
what
the
late?
Pace at a high level
match
where they wanted
by
it.
Match won Peter
yeah.
Rasmussen, Thomas Stango, 21-8, 21-10.
I'm at a loss for words. It's I don't have anything.
No. They were just too fast, much too fast.
Hopefully we get the chance tomorrow to see the finals, the men's doubles 40 finals, because I want to see those Danes again. They were really, really impressive.
Yeah, and they'll be up against Trikus and Harianto Arbi.
Yeah.
In the final.
Yes, which we've also seen before with Arbi, so that should be a really good final. So next is another doubles, Thai couple versus a Danish couple. So we'll take a break for a few minutes. We're right back. We're going to get into the second to last game of the day. We have men's doubles 60, and it's a Thai couple, and apologies for their pronunciation. We have Jamsak Panichaikul. That should be, let's see if I can read the backs. Can you see which is which?
That's the guy
Jamsak.
At the close end, no? That guy.
Is that Jamsak?
No, they have their first names on their back, so it's the other way around.
Yes, so Jamsak, that's not Jamsak you see in picture. That's Surapong Suharit Dumrong. Apologies for the pronunciation. So it's Jamsak and Surapong. Easier to pronounce their first names.
Yeah, and that's the ones they have on their back also.
Yes, so let's go with that. And they are up against the second seeded Danish pair. It's Klaus Andersen and Jesper Helledi. Jesper Helledi. And which one is which?
Jesper Helledi is the one we have in picture now. He's an old club mate of mine from Vidor.
Okay, so that's Jesper and Klaus.
And he also has won the professional world championships in Copenhagen in 1983, I think.
And I'm pretty sure, yes, this is the 82. we actually showed their quarterfinals.
Okay.
Jesper and Klaus. Michael, my previous commentating partner, he spoke very highly of Jesper and Klaus, and they showed it on the court as well.
Yes.
Very, very high quality for, you know, it doesn't look like 60 plus. They look very, very young and healthy and fast.
Jesper actually won the All England men's doubles last year in the 50 plus. So he often goes down and plays the younger players. Klaus did the same a few years back. Did Michael tell you that yesterday?
No, but I've heard that because my father, who plays in the 50, he got walloped by Jesper a couple of years ago.
Okay.
A few years older. That says a lot. That you can go down a couple of classes and still
Klaus,
be the absolute best.
Yeah, Klaus did that. He said he wanted to play in the men's singles 40 a few years back when he was 10 years ago then. And the Danes first said no, but he said he wouldn't play if he didn't get to play in 10 years with the guys who were 10 years younger. And they eventually let him play, and he won the whole thing in the men's singles.
So
that's the quality of those two players.
Yeah, that's very, very cool. So Klaus and Jesper, as I said, second seed. And Jamsak and Suopong, they are third and fourth seeded. So they're both right up there where they're supposed to be in the seed. So it should be a good game. This should be two of the better pairs in this class.
Definitely. I think we'll see an attacking game from the Danes and a more defensive game from the players from Thailand.
Should start the introductions.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Jamsak Panichaikul, Surapong, Suharit Dumrong, Thailand. And on my left, Klaus Andersen, Jesper Helledi, Denmark. Klaus Andersen to serve, to Jamsak Panichaikul. Love all. Play. Service over. One love.
Looking at the
service over. 1-0.
The previous record for these pairs in this class, this tournament, they have both absolutely smashed their opponents. Two setters, and the opponent got below 10 points in each set. So it's been both the Danes and the Thais has been better than their opponents so far. So it should be a good clash here.
Service over. 2-0. Service over. 3-2. Service over. 3-0. Service over. 4-3.
Looked like a pretty short serve. Able to utilize.
Mm-hmm.
Able to take advantage of it.
Service over. 4-0.
Judging from the coaching chairs, the Danes should win this quite easily because they have no coaches. They don't think they need any.
That's a statement.
Service over.
High level.
6.
A little bit
five.
Of a weak smash. Able to just redirect it to the opposite corner.
Out. Service over.
I wonder
six,
if yes.
All.
Jesper's nervous because he has missed two serves now. Or one short, and then this one.
Service over. 7-6. Service over, 7-0. Yep. 8-7.
That's better
over,
Mr. Hennedy.
8-0.
They were lucky on that one, the Danes.
Service over.
Jesper is having a couple misses.
All.
Yeah, he's not happy with his game so far.
Yeah.
Shaking his head at several times.
Yeah. Yeah, maybe Peter and Klaus, maybe they are the most surprised about the way they're playing right now.
I don't think they've really got their engine started, so to say.
Yeah.
Play.
Almost double hit. Oh.
Maybe they're still assessing their opponents. I don't know if they've met before. They maybe haven't met previously. Yeah. He's still, I think, Jesper is still the best doubles player on the court of the four of them, from what I've seen so far.
Service over, 12-13.
And as you said, they haven't really had any opposition before in the earlier rounds. So maybe they need to adjust their game a little now. Yeah. Oops.
Service over.
I think he smashed a racket there. Still serving quite short
15,
when he flicks.
13.
I think he's like daring the opponents to attack.
Service over 14-15.
Yeah, so the Thai couple actually came second in Ankara 2 years ago.
Okay.
In the 55 class.
In the 65?
The 55.
55, okay.
So
they're younger.
Service
yeah.
over. 16-14. Service over. 15-16. Service over. 17-15. Service over.
As you can see, Klaus isn't as solid
16,
in his defense as
17.
Jesper is.
Service over, 18-17.
That's good placement.
You can see he always has plenty of time
19,
to do what he wants with the shuttle.
Yeah, he was really, he got the ball and he just placed it where he wanted.
Yeah.
And the time was running around trying to pick it up.
Change.
And he's always ready for what they're coming, because he knows what they're doing before they do it. It's too short.
Service over. 18,
I think he forgets
19.
That Klaus isn't as good in his defense as
Jesper.
Jesper is.
Out. Service over. 20.
Expensive
game point. 18.
Ooh.
Game.
Okay, they called it out.
Yeah.
I would
this
also.
Game won by Klaus,
it was close.
Jesper Helledy, 21-18.
Always hard with the flat shots, to assess if they're in or out.
But Jesper called for him to let it go, so he felt it was out.
Yeah. Yeah, so a little bit of a struggle for the Danes.
I think they had a few too many unforced errors in the beginning of that game, and if they continue to play the same way they are now, it should be a bit easier in the second game. But again, there's this guy down, someone in the audience coaching Danish players.
Yeah. I think the umpire mentioned that as well.
And Klaus is still seeking advice from the from the person in the audience.
Mm. Second game, love all, play. Service over, one love. Service over, one all. Service over, 2-1.
Jesper is one of the few players that I've seen today who's doing the forehand serve.
Yes.
Very rare nowadays overall, I think.
It is, yes, indeed.
Service over, 2-2.
He and Klaus are probably two of the few who still use the forehand serve in doubles.
That's good. A little bit of...
3-2.
The tie in the back, I think he was... a bit hesitant to hit the ball because I think it was Sorapong was too close below.
Yeah.
Service over.
Yeah.
3-3.
That was good defense by Sorapong. I think that the serve, the smash return, that was placed in the opposite
service
corner. That really threw Jesper.
4-3.
Good. Ah.
Service over. 4-0.
Good defense from the Thailand players there.
Go! Service over. 5-6.
It's still hard to see who's going to come out ahead in this game.
Six all.
I'm still looking for the second gear of the Danes, but they haven't found it yet. It's very even.
No, the game is very tentative, as you say. Both couples, I think, are still trying to
Service
find...
Service over. 7-6.
Good.
Service over. 7-7. Out. Service over. 8-7.
Yeah, I don't think the Danes are very happy with their play right now. It's a lot of mistakes.
Yeah, and I don't think they were expecting the couple from Thailand to be quite so offensive as they are. And that has worked out well for them.
Yeah, they seem to know they can't find any momentum in the game. They get the point and then they miss a serve. And then they lose 2 points, and they win the a shuttle, and then they get it, and then they serve in the net. You know, it's they never get going with the points. They just get stuck with a mistake.
Yeah.
11-7. Play.
I think that could be mainly because their opponents are not allowing them to play the game they want to play. So it's good tactics from the players from Thailand so far in the second game.
Fault. Service over. 8-12.
Good Danish defense.
Yes.
Never get their offense going. It's offense by the tie, and then they recover and then go right into tie offense again.
Yes.
Hold.
Yeah. Once again.
15.
Yes, I think
eight.
They're effectively taking away time for the Danes. So they're not having enough time to play the game they would like to play.
Who was gonna take that one, the last one? It's good positioning.
17-8.
The Danes really need to score a couple of points now to stay in this game. Placement Thailand is solid.
Very
not
solid.
Getting through.
Yeah, exactly. It's good to prevent offense by having a good defense, because then, usually the offense 19, and defense swap
eight.
Places because of a bad defense, and you get the momentum in your favor. But if the defense is solid, then they get nothing.
And that's the way it's looking for the Danes right now.
Yeah.
They're getting nothing. And probably, as you said, they haven't had any real competition in the championship so far, Klaus and Jesper, so they're not used to this. They have to find a way through this.
Game!
Yeah,
second game won by Jamsak.
This is not what we expected. Nothing, none of us.
21-8.
Especially not
one
the
game
Danish
all.
Couple. They really need to regroup now and find a new plan of attack.
Yeah.
For the rest of this match.
Yeah, looking at the record, they played their first game, beat two Swedish players, Lars Ubay and Sören Molin, and two sets, and then. No, wait, that's wrong. Okay, so they beat the Dutch team 21-5, 21-5. That's the first game. And then they beat two Malaysian players 21-12, 21-7. That's the quarterfinals. And now in this the second game. And then the quarterfinals, they beat Arne Hjelstrup and Christian Hansen from Denmark, 21-6, 21-5.
Yeah.
So they've been really ripping through their bracket.
They haven't been tested yet. So this couple from Thailand is really putting them to the test now. Let's see how they do in the third game.
Service over. One love.
I don't think Klaus and Jesper have played at this level before in the championships. Not that I've seen anyway or heard of.
Together, you mean?
Together, yeah.
1-0. Two, one. Okay.
The players seem to think the shuttle was in and the linesman called it out.
Yeah, tied and look at the line judge.
Yeah. Neither did the Danes, because they, they were all ready for 3-1.
Yeah.
Service over.
Counter three, offense with two. More offense.
Yes.
It's a good tactic.
Service over.
Short.
3-0. Service over. 4-3.
I can't see any change in the Danish couple's plan so far. And they really need to change something up.
Yeah.
Because if they keep going like this, they're not going to be standing as winners at the end of the game, the match.
Exactly the right position, so he could just stand there and smack it down the floor. That was good positioning or just luck, I don't know. He's very fast.
And they have been attacking more on Klaus B than they have been on Jesper there.
Jesper. Yep.
I think they're sensing that Klaus isn't really a doubles player. Hesitation
again.
There again, yeah.
9-4.
The Danes are trying to be a bit more offensive now, more aggressive in their attacking game. Let's see if it will help them.
Service over. 10-6.
We need to try something at least.
Another miss 11-6. In the communication between the Danish players.
Yeah.
I'd try to hear something from the Danish players, but they don't seem to be talking to each other.
Court 4, 20 seconds. Court 4, 20 seconds. Klaus. 11-6. Play.
This is how the Danes want to play, with Klaus in the back and Jesper at the net.
So far has done that a lot, just anticipating where it's going and pounces on it right at the net.
Yes, yes. They've been taking, as I said, they've been taking away the time, taking the shuttle early.
Service over.
To put pressure on the Danish couple after the first game.
Service
That's
over.
Good attacking game for the Danes.
8-13.
Good defending.
Yes, very good rally.
Yeah, they were able to aim the smash returns. That's a really good way to stop the smashing from happening.
Yeah.
I try to aim it away from them.
I think it's a mistake for Klaus to take the net as often as he's doing, for the Danish couple's sake. But this time they got away with it.
Service over, 14-10.
Could have been a deciding point for the outcome of this game.
Yeah.
Big difference between 10-16 and 11-15. Ah, good shot, Klaus.
Sarasova, 11-16. Sarasova, 19-20, match point, 12.
It's not only that the Jesper and Klaus are underperforming, but that, you know, the tie is, it's not like they don't deserve the victory. They are playing really well.
Yeah, I don't think Jesper and Klaus are underachieving. I think the tie couple have taken away the time for them. They're not in the game. They were better today.
Very, yeah, exactly.
They turned it around after the first game, totally.
Yeah, it was very impressive.
Thank you, Sarapong. Thank you very much. Thank you, Klaus.
Match won by Yamsak, Panichai Kul, Sarapong, Suhari Drumong, 18-21, 21-8, 21-3. Thank you.
21-13, he means. It wasn't 21-3 in the third game.
Oh, 21-13. Okay, a little bit of an upset, but entertaining nonetheless. Very good play by the Thais. So we're gonna come up to the last game of the day, the last semifinal. It's going to be, we pick a really good game for to be the last one. We're gonna see Tony Gunawan and Flandi Limpele from America and Indonesia, but they're both Indonesian. They're gonna go up against Anders Boesen, who's gonna be the third time we show him here, and Andreas Borella, two Danish guys. So this is doubles, men's doubles 35 plus, coming up in a few minutes. Be right back.
Thank you.
Now we're going to go into the possibly the last game of the night. We have conflicting schedules, so we might have one more. I think it was a mixed. So we just hang tight after the game, and maybe there is one more. So this is this is men's doubles, 35 plus. This is Tony Gunawan, which is to the left, on the side of the court. And he's playing with Flandy Limpele, close to the court, to the left. And this is the second time that we show him. We showed their quarterfinals yesterday as well. It was a good game, and they really show that they have the world-class experience, both of them. And they're up against Anders Boosen again for the third time with us. And he's playing with Andreas Borella, two Danes, and they are third and fourth seeded in this class. So, Tony Gunawan, a big name, I've heard.
Yes, he's won the world championships at least twice, I think. And he has won one gold medal for the USA, who he's still playing for. He moved there from Indonesia. And he's a big name in badminton.
And I heard yesterday that Flandy Limpele, he played badminton in Athens, in the Olympics. And I think he reached the quarterfinals. I don't know if it was in doubles or singles, but he reached the Olympics at least. So that says something about his skill.
Yes, they're both quality players.
Yes.
And all four of them, actually.
Yes, the Danes, Anders Boosen, we know that he is a bit of a hothead from what we've seen these 2 days. He's a passionate player. And Andreas Borella, I don't know much about them.
Ready, Anders? Ladies and gentlemen,
we learn more
on my
as the game
right,
progresses. Then.
Flandy Limpele, Indonesia, Tony Gunawan, USA. On my left, Andreas Borella, Anders Boosen, Denmark. Anders Boosen to serve to Flandy Limpele, love all, play. Service fault called, service over.
It seems like Mr. Boosen has caught the eye of the officials.
Right on the first serve. Uh-oh.
To love. Fault. Service over. 1-2. Let.
That was a good serve, otherwise.
Andreas is very quick to serve.
Serve is over. 3-2.
Almost, Limpele was almost wasn't ready.
Leon.
The second time.
Over.
Great return from Anders there.
2-4.
I noticed that Anders is also using the forehand serve.
5-2.
So maybe it wasn't as unusual as we thought before.
Player.
6-2.
Great rally.
Looked so casual as well. He was completely dominating the tempo, and he flew around there looking very casual.
Yeah, good play there.
It's over.
Yeah, I've heard that the general idea about the forehand versus backhand short serve is that the forehand is less. Because it's more moving parts, it's less easy to make consistent.
could be.
Great defense, yeah.
Another advantage that they've said is that you get more deception on the flick with
seven,
using the backhand serve.
Three.
Yeah. Than on the front. Easier to hide it.
Yes.
Yeah.
Fault.
Mm.
Service over. 4-7.
Did she call a fault on the service?
I think it was the wrong player receiving the serve.
Five, seven.
I thought she called the service fault, but it must have been another court.
Yeah.
Service fault called.
Again, Anders.
Service over. 8-5.
So she's, if I'm reading her sign right, she's saying that the racket head is not pointing in a downwards direction. And he's striking the shuttle.
That's good.
Relentless attack.
9-5.
Yes, if they go into the offensive mode. If they come into the offensive mode, then it's very hard to stop them.
Yep.
That's good. Push them out in the corners. Yeah.
Very good defense from the Danes.
Yeah, they were able
to break
the smashes by putting
yes.
it on at the edge of the courts.
Nine.
Very good.
Over 10-6. Service over 7-10. Service over, 11-7, interval.
No one really thinks that, most people don't think that any couple will be able to challenge Gunnarsson or beat Gunnarsson in Pelle. So I think the Danes are putting up a very good game so far.
Yeah, it's... I find it hard to analyze because the balls are so quick.
Court 4, 20 seconds.
The tempo
four,
when they start
seconds.
Playing is so high that I find it difficult to find anything to say. Because they,
11,
but they
seven,
have 7 points.
Play.
So I guess they're doing something right.
Now one thing I think they've been doing is having Gunnarsson trying to get Tony to the back of the court. Rather than having me at the front, and I think that's definitely something they should continue to do. Because when he's at the front
13,
of the court,
seven.
They're not going to have much of a chance.
No, if you start smashing, it's difficult to stop him.
14-7.
He's super dangerous at the net as well.
15,
hard to stop
seven.
Him.
What I'm saying, they have to get him away from the front of the court.
Okay, okay.
But when they've been scoring their points, they've had Tony at the back of the court.
Okay.
Service over. 8-15. Service over. 16-8. Seventeen, 8.
Again, they got Tony to the back of the court, and they could score a point eventually.
9-70. Fault. 10-17. Service over, 18-10.
He's just too fast.
20, game point, 10. Anders.
Tony Gunnarsson show.
Yeah.
Damn.
First game won by
as
Tony
as he
Gunnarsson.
Gets to the front of the court, he's able to run the show, so
yeah,
to say.
Yeah.
And he decides where and how it will be played.
Very impressive. So Tony and Flandy's previous games. We saw the quarterfinals against Casper Erdem and Tommy Sørensen yesterday. 21-16, 21-13, so pretty comfortable victory there.
Mm-hmm.
And then they played against Torsten Hugride, which it was the mixed, our first mixed, Torsten and Michaela Hugride from Germany. And Torsten and Ewood Tan. From Holland, from Netherlands. They beat them 21-10, 21-15. And then a British couple, 21-9, 21-19. So yeah, two setters all the way.
Anders, receiving.
Yeah, let's see what the Danes can do in this game then.
Second game, love all, play. One love. Service over. 1-1. Service over.
Andreas,
two,
you can't
one.
Afford that kind of mistake here.
Service over. 3-2.
So she's raising his arm. She's raising her arm, indicating the direction of the racket.
Yes, that sign is supposed to mean that the racket head is not pointing downwards.
Another sign. Yes. Another sign. 3-2.
It can't be pointing upwards or
play.
Flat. It has to be pointed downwards at the moment of impact with the shuttle.
Over. 3-0.
Not a bad flick serve. A little bit lucky
four,
there.
4-3.
Ampella read that.
Yep.
Yes.
That's well read by Andreas.
5-3. Service over. 4-5.
The decision between the Danish players there. But they kept him at the back of the court again.
Yeah.
And that's when they get their points.
Service over. 7-6.
You cannot play Tony in that region of the court and get away with it. It's very well left.
Yes. 7-8.
Just slightly out.
It's a good flick serve.
Very good. Longest rally of the match so far.
Oh.
A great rally.
Yeah. The crowd is appreciating the effort. Damn, that was a good rally.
Andreas had to change his racket for some reason. Maybe he broke a string when he hit the shot in the net. In there. See if he can keep his racket down this time. The head of the racket sits there.
Yeah.
Fault.
Oh.
Service over. 11-8 the interval.
Yeah. Yeah, interesting with the server Buesen. Because I thought at first the fault was because he was trying to do a flick serve and he was just, you know, twitching a little bit too much. Yeah. But he was getting faults on the short serves as well.
Yes.
So,
20 seconds.
Yeah, I don't know. It feels like, you know, you have the way you do your serve, and if every 10 of the serves gets, or every fifth of the serve gets faulted,
play.
No, it should create some doubt in your head, I guess, when you serve.
He should be prepared to should have a plan for how to change his serve so as not to get caught.
No.
Both Tony and Limpele were so fast to get into the net.
Service over.
Yep.
9-13. Service over. 14-9.
I don't think the Danish players are used to the shuttle coming back as fast as it's coming back in this game.
Yeah, but it was wrong before. Sorry. 14-9. Play.
Oops.
Yep.
A little too tense there.
Good
I think.
15-9.
I don't think Tony's done many flick serves, so. Yeah. Damn. That's an Olympics class smash right there. Olympiada. Yeah, they're trying to push Tony into the backfield, but then they get Limpele at the net, and he's pretty good as well.
Yeah, he's not as good as Tony, but he's very good also.
Service over. 10-18. Service over. 19-10. Game.
And there we have it. Total symmetry in the scoring line.
Yeah, the Tony Show again. Very impressive. I'm just as impressed with them as I was yesterday when I saw the quarterfinals.
Yeah.
They're on a different level than the pairs they met so far.
I think they're on a different level than everyone else in the tournament, actually.
Yeah. Tony probably one of the best, if not the best player here.
We saw the previous men's doubles 35 also, didn't we? The English couple, King and...
That's 40.
Thank you.
That's 40,
thank
okay.
You.
Mm. So the finals in doubles 35 is going to be Tony and Flandy against... let's see who's going to be the other one. Going to be it's going to be it's going to be Chaimak and Tirarat Sakul. It's
from
a Thai couple.
Thailand, right?
Yeah. Okay. I beat a Dutch couple in the semis. We didn't see that one here. So we might have another game. Depending on who has the right schedule here, so
men's doubles 45, I think.
Yeah,
it could be.
Could be. Mm-hmm. So yes, be right back in a second.
Match 2002, women's double plus 35, Chen Huawei and Chen Yufang, Chinese Taipei versus Katsumi Ichino and Naruko Sanada, Japan, court number
games on this court today. There was going to be a men's doubles, but it's being played on another court. So we're going to start tomorrow at 11 o'clock with the finals of all the classes. We don't have the schedule for which finals we're going to show, but it will be up on the tournament's tournament software. Probably tonight. Today's schedule was up last night. So go check there if you want to know in beforehand. But other than that, see you at 11 o'clock tomorrow morning. Bye!